scrapbook from Peter. See? Look! That's me! Look at me! There! You're lucky you weren't killed!
So my first time to Japan, it was me, Jake, Bailey, Diego, and Luke. Jake just hyped it up. He's like, we want to do this with Bailey. I was like, oh, okay, perfect.
It barely happened for me. I didn't have a ticket, and everybody else had their tickets. But it was like, they got to bring me.
I traveled with Jake from the time I was 21 till the past. For like 25 years, we traveled together.
Definitely never traveled with him, never been in a car with him, never like exclusive much, like anything.
Yeah, he was so stoked on this trip. I don't know if it was his first time in Japan either, but yeah, it was all new to him too. Yeah, Jake put it together. Bailey made all the arrangements, did all the recon, and figured out where to go.
By all means necessary, we had to go to this park on the North Island of Japan and have enough time to skate, like 2 or 3 days. Went to a ferry port, got ferry ticket, and put the van on the ferry for like, dude, like 15 hours.
Yeah, little did I know we were gonna have to take like a 2-day ferry ride to get there. We had bunks and shit.
20 hour tour.
This is where I didn't get seasick.
It was like overnight. It was gnarly.
What am I gonna do? Should I throw it overboard and sink with it?
I went to take a shower just to explore it. And it went in there, and there was a big hot tub. There's people floating around in the hot tub. It was insane.
Hokkaido's its own full realm, North Island of Japan. It's like, it's a pretty special deal. A lot of snow. We just had to get there.
The Lost Skate Park, Jake quoted it, the Lost Skate Park, because he's like, Bones Brigade was supposed to come here in the 80s, and they just never came, and it's just been sitting here, just rotting.
It was kind of an issue to find the skate park. Right. Mountain roads, you know. I don't know how we found that thing without any info. It was cool because Pete and I were like super tight, traveled all the time, grew up together. Jake and Luke were Jake and Luke. And then Diego was thrown in and it was like, cool. Diego, he's like South American in the mix.
So we got there at night and climbed into this giant thermometer looking thing. And Jake's like, let's make a fire and try to skate.
And then we were really stoked after we somewhat foolishly lit a fire and I think it fucked the surface of it up. I know some of the people were disgruntled.
I think it was a bottle that he filled with gas and chucked it in there just like, and when it landed in there, it went.
Made a killer photo, but it was probably kind of fucked.
Hey, Luke, I'm gonna throw what's gas in there, everybody duck.
Hold on, wait.
It's on, red light means go.
I mean, dude, this grind, like at night with a fire, that bottom part is gnarly, dude. It's like 3 feet of vert, I'd say. And then a flash that blasted down the whole fucking half pipe with like probably some side fill flashes that just completely, I remember it, it completely blinds him. There's probably video, he's probably just like.
And we didn't know where we were, like it was pitch black dark.
This one Polaroid, it's taller than the bull.
No, I took a photo from back there. It was fucking 30 feet high. It was like, oh.
Good night. But we camped there. We slept there. We did the whole fucking thing.
Bailey doesn't bring, he's bare minimalist, so he probably had the airplane blanket.
I slept in the bowl. That's my setup right there with the airplane blanket and a pillow. It was only one night, but it was like pretty cold and harsh.
So we go to bed and we get up in the morning. Jake's like coming down the hill and he's like, come here, you gotta see this. So we get in there and start riding again. It's just crusty. It's like chunks of concrete falling off. And it was bad. I mean, they still skate the fucking thing. And they skated better than we skated it back then. And it's way crustier now.
I do remember that the ladder was in a different place.
Yeah, I think you can hear Jake orchestrating that one.
But if you shoot it like this, you get just the perspective of what's down there, right? Yeah.
Bailey just did it like fucking how many times you need it. It kept getting better and better and better too.
Yeah. It's hard to like do two turns and then be at that right spot for a ladder.
Yeah, Jaya.
I think I got a phone call, like landline at the house, and they're like, dude, you got a photo from the trip on a cover. Just, like, sat on that for at least a week or so until it came around, probably.
Yeah, it was great to see. He deserves it. And especially at that time, he deserved it. I don't even need to explain. It's just Bailey.
I had some music. I had mixtapes and a radio and shit that totally got incorporated. And like, it's even in the cover photo. Like, somebody stuck it under the ladder and like mentions it in the caption and shit.
People thought it was photoshopped. I remember hearing that all the time. I'm like, really? Why would you think that?
That's just an ollie over like a fucking super skinny ladder, dude. Whatever. Luke made it look cool, I think, and the spot like captivated a lot of people and it was cool. It's just a dream. Like, doing that whole trip with those people at that time was so rad.
Thanks, Bailey, for making that all happen. That was amazing.
That's my guy.
Just so lucky, dude. Doesn't happen like that, dude. You don't get to do shit like that. Like, it's just unreal, dude.
This is for all the kids that counted me out in grade school.
I think about them like when I'm skating, obviously. And I think about them a lot when I have questions that I want answers to.
Hey, it's for you, bro.
Thanks, man.
Remember this finger.
Is that the only bird you know?